Thank you. It's a lovely view.
Is this on, Chris?
Right. Thank you. Lovely view up here. I'm so glad I've got this really behind me, though. Well, after all those lists of concerts by Chris, I would have a word about today's rather humble offering in comparison. Wesley, choral song and fugue. No, not the fugue, not playing the fugue. Choral song. Takes the form of a rondo. The first eight bars you're going to hear again and again and again. And it's quite a majestic piece. A lot of British music of the 19th century has that kind of a confidence and majesty about them, and this is one example. Bach, well-tempered clavier, and you probably know, clavier, keyboard, is interchangeable keyboard, any keyboard. So nowadays, you could hear the 48 on the clavichord, the harpsichord, the organ, or the piano over there behind you. So choice of four today in 2024. The prelude, a gentle jig, 9/8 time. The fugue, much more vocal based. It could be sung easily by a four-part SATB choir. Elgar, the Andantino, an early work from the 1890s, predates the famous works like Enigma, but you can really hear his genius for writing a good tune. Oh, with the Wesley comes from 1840, so it's about 30 years older than this organ. So after, no, it's Leighton next. Leighton also quotes his own music because he wrote his Fanfare at the same time, the mid-1960s, as he was writing one of his biggest organ works, Et Resurrexit. And that work consists of a four-note motif heard in the major version, la 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 la, or the minor, la 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 la. And you'll hear in the Fanfare that Leighton quotes the minor version. Both pieces are triumphant at the end, but you feel in both of the words, like this Fanfare, that triumph doesn't come without a struggle. Then downstairs, we have sacred and secular. Sacred, Frescobaldi. The L'Elevazione refers to the moment of the Roman Catholic Mass when standing at the altar, the priest lifts the bread and wine to commemorate the events of the Last Supper. And whilst that's happening, organists such as Frescobaldi would have been improvising an expressive organ piece to accompany the liturgical action. And this piece is full of wonderful dissonance. If you like kind of clashes of harmonic clashes, this is a piece for you. Then to the secular, a very jolly dance tune by Sweelinck. You hear the tune and then four variations. Back up here, Liszt Consolation, originally a piano piece, but sounds good on the organ. And budding students, music students, could treat it as a nice orchestration exercise. There's plenty of scope. Enceladus by my friend Chester Clark, who is a third year music student at Glasgow University. He's in his third year studying composition, plays the oboe, sings in a choir where I met him, and he wrote this piece for me. Enceladus, one of the moons of Saturn. It's very, very cold, even colder than the Scottish winter. So much so that there is a blanket of ice covering the whole moon all the time, which makes it a very reflective celestial body. You can see it for miles around, or space miles around. It's very bright, gleaming ice. And then Macmillan. Again, I gave the first performance of this way back in 2018 at the wedding of James's son, Aidan, to his Albanian wife, Clyda. The tune, Kenya, is a traditional Albanian dance tune played on kind of pipes and percussion. And James arranges it for organ in a very kind of a, I think he had in mind Arthur Benjamin's Jake and Rumba. They're both in the key of C major, and they both have the ongoing dom, 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 dom rumba rhythm. So before I play a word, it's going to take me some time to get from there to there, so feel free to kind of stand up, have a stretch, move around as my osteopath recommends. The human body was made for movement, so do feel free to have a stretch once I go from there down to there and then back again. Thank you.
you've got one highlight, which goes to the Patrick Cathedral, which has a unique theme. The organ is very high up, really, really high up. And normally you'd expect a kind of flight of spiral stairs. The organist has his own lift. There's a special elevator just for the organist to take you up to the organ at the West End with the music box next door. It's a it's wonderful, very nice. Nothing here.